Good morning and welcome, dear friends. Welcome to the CEC live lecture session. In today's session, we'll be taking a topic that is Empowerment Through Cooperatives, a case study of women cooperatives in India. And to discuss this topic with us in studios, we have Dr. Namita Rajput. Dr. Rajput is principal of Sri Aurobindo Evening College, which falls under University of Delhi. Dr. Namita has a 26 years of vast experience in teaching and mentoring in Delhi University. Friends, before starting this discussion, I would remind you that if you have any questions and queries regarding this ongoing session, you can call us on our toll-free number, and our toll-free number is 1-800-110-430. So let's welcome Dr. Namita Rajput to the studios and let's get started with the topic. Welcome to the studios, ma'am, and please start the topic.
Yeah. Good morning, friends. The topic of today is Women Empowerment, India's Context in the Cooperatives. Women were often excluded from the economic decisions in India due to their dependence on their male counterparts. Although women did not engage in remunerative activities, they were quite skilled to a great extent in crafts like embroidery, weaving, cooking, etc. With the beginning of the cooperative movement in India, women found a platform to utilize their craft, talent, and become financially independent and contribute to the family earnings. Women found it necessary to form a consumer societies as the price of essential commodities were rising speedily and a problem of adulteration had become a very serious damage and a danger. Now, with the formation of the basically the women industrial cooperatives, women cooperative banks and the women multi-purpose societies also begin to be formed. Utilization of the women labor for productive purposes under the cooperative movements can increase the gross national income, and this can help to activate, achieve our objective of socio-economic development. The cooperative provide many, many varied opportunities for the women participation. No doubt, their standard of living is improved by the income they earn from the cooperatives, and the quality of the life is engaged and enhanced due to the social awareness, entrepreneurship development of the skills, increased participation in the affairs of the cooperatives, the leading to a better understanding and, of course, utility. Most of the women cooperatives in India have proven very, very successful, but they face a cutthroat competition in the market. Women cooperatives suffer undue escalation of the cost and the limited availability of the raw material. Now, when you talk about the success stories of the women cooperatives in India, it has been very, very tough. Women, you know, used to have a very stereotyped role in the Indian society. She was very confined to cooking, to taking care of children, you know, confined to four walls. But yes, as the need demands, as the case may be, there was a great need to enhance the income of the family. Now, when the rise of the needs of the family is there, and the women had skills, so this led to the rise of the cooperative movement in India. Specifically, when you talk about the women's skills, women are multi-skilled persons, and that was definitely proved. Why and how? It was proved by the cooperative movements in India. So we'll give you some success stories, how the women cooperatives increased, but there were so many limitations which were cut across, and the women became the leaders. Now, as far as the women cooperatives is concerned, there were so many limitations, so many inhibitions, so many problems which they faced. The first and the foremost problem was of the finance. The second was of the raw material. Nothing was, you know, served to them on a platter. They had to struggle. They had to, you know, really take care of the needs of the family. So they did a lot of hard work. They applied all their skills to the par excellence. And only then the success came to them. Now, just look at the screen, the awe-inspiring narrative of Lijjat Papad and the Indian dreams. So, this is a very, very interesting case study of the women cooperatives in India, how their dream became a reality, how the success came to the women. This is, let us, you know, do this in detail. Let me give you an overview of this case study. Shri Mahila Udyog Lijjat Papad, popularly known as Lijjat, currently presided by Jyoti Nayak. Indian women cooperatives involved in manufacturing of various fast-moving consumer goods, that is FMCG. Now, this concept of Lijjat Papad Udyog, which was started by the women, it started it way back in 1959. With just imagine, with a very small seed capital of rupees 80, and that too was borrowed from the Changal Karamasi Parik. Lijjat has an annual turnover of around rupees 550 crores, with about 229 crores in exports until the last decades. So see their journey, how they started and how, you know, the exports increased to many folds. So this is quite interesting. Let me give you some history of this. It began with just 7 semi-illiterate ladies and a borrowed sum of rupees 80. It was founded in Giragam, Mumbai in 1959. Expanded as a cooperative. It started with the production of 4 packets of papads. In 1962, the name Lijjat, that is Gujarati for tasty, was chosen by the group of its products. Then, let us talk about some of the beginnings. In 1962, Lijjat expanded as a cooperative system. The first year, the organization's annual sales were rupees 6,196 with a seed capital of rupees 80, that was also a borrowed capital. The name Lijjat was chosen by the group of its products by, you know, Dhirya Bhim Rupail. The organization was named Shri Mahila Gira Udyog Lijjat Papa. By 1962-63, its annual sales of papad touched rupees 1.82 lakhs. Now, the mothers of the Lijjat Papad founder list. Let us have a list and recognize these women. You know, they were the founders. The first was Jaswanti Ben Jamnadas, Popad Parvetin Ramdas Jodani, Uja Ben Narandas Kunglani, Banu Ben N. Tana, Lagu Ben Amrita Gokani, Jaya Ben Ved Mithilani, and one more lady whose name is not known. Now, what were their collective dreams? The objective of Lijjat institution is to provide the employment to the ladies to enable them to earn a very decent and dignified livelihood. The vision of the organization is to enable the women to become self-reliant and self-confident. What was the primary aim? The primary objective is to maximize the employment opportunities for women through activities connected with the village industries, while at the same time not sacrificing the basic business principles and the quality consciousness. We are a full-fledged commercial self-reliant organization, not a charitable society. Any such benefits that occur are incidental to our business. Now, the Vimal Bhim M. Pavale, ex-president, Shri Mahila Gira Udyog Lijjat Papad. The next was social service. Distributing the nutritious food for the poor children, contributing money for conducting the community money for conducting the community marriage, give the prize money for widening the primary education, organizing the health camps, drive for plantation. Now, Srimati Rukmani B. Pawar, that is the Lijjat president, praised by the Mumbai city in 1999 as an outstanding woman in the field of the social work. Chincholi, that is the Jogan, the earthquake affected the village in the Latur district of Maharashtra, which was reconstructed by Lijjat. The finance and the supervision work of reconstruction of 58 houses for the people of the village are provided by Lichit. After the Gujarat earthquake in 2001, all the branches of Lichit donated more than 4.8 million, including rupees 1 million from the central office. Lichit built for a reformation of the people of Bhujur, that is the Bachao in Kutch district, 40 houses. Now, there are certain core values which needs to be addressed, which were of the Lichit Papad Udyog. Now, let us talk about those core values. An organization of the women, for the women, by the women. Pledge to ensure that all get the fruits of the labor. No harm is caused to the institution. Synthesis of three different concepts: the concept of business, production of quality, goods at a reasonable prices, the concept of family, the mutual family affection, concern and the trust. The concept of devotion and the work is worship. Now, there are certain unique and novel initiatives. It is primarily a cottage industry, urban in its organization and origin. It has eventually spread to the rural areas and to other cities and towns in several states of India. It provides the self-employment, dignity of labor, earning capacity of women. In contrast to other Indian women, the workers actually own Lichit, collective ownership. The company is a cooperative that implements Mahatma Gandhi's principles of self-help and trusteeship. Now, let me talk about something about the evolution of Lichit Papad, that how Lichit Papad evolved. The membership has expanded from an initial number of 7 sisters from one building to about 42,000 sisters throughout the year. So, see this immense rise, enhanced rise in the number of sisters, which expanded the business. The organization is widespread with its central office in Mumbai, 67 branches, 35 divisions in different states all over India. The venture started with rupees 80 and the annual sales from 6196 in 1959 to more than 3 billion in 2002, with export itself exceeding to 12 crores. Now, let me give you some products which they make. The first is papad. You'll be amazed to know that papad comes in 14 flavors, which are exotic, magnificent, aromatic. Then we had khakra, apalam, masala, vadi, gehu atta, that is the wheat flour, some bakery items, chapati, sasa detergent powder, sasa detergent cakes, that is tikkia, sasa neelam detergent powder, sasa liquid detergent, manufacturing unit, that is the dahisar, and the office, that is the Borivali. The production of papads. The production process started at 4.30 a.m. in the morning. The system members collect their respective dough and start rolling the dough. The rolled dough is then dried on the piece of the cloth in the sunlight. When it gets dried, it is the beginning of the quality department. The checking is done batch-wise and it does not conform to the Lichit standards, then the whole batch is disposed of. So, this kind of quality control is very, very important for them because they are so bothered for the quality checks. If the complete lot is not up to the mark and not up to the standards, the whole batch will be disposed of. Now, if you see this picture on the screen, you can see how these women are working day and night with such good environment, with a clean environment, so that whatever comes out is of good quality. They take care of all basic quality standards. They basically maintain the hygiene, which is there. You can see it very clearly. Now let us see the advertisement of this Lijjat Papad. It begins with the word of mouth, concentrated more on cost effectiveness and quality. It uses both the electronic and the print media. The motivation factors for the distributors. How it promotes the product is very simple. The USP of the brand is definitely having the strength of consistently good quality. It promoted the crispness and the quality through ads. The maximum advertisement is done by airing on the various channels. Then we have certain things about the culture and the uniqueness. Now basically the Lijjat Paprika in the house magazine, no machinery used to do at a production level. The role of women empowerment is there. The contribution to the social service is there. Now let me give you something about the organization and the management. Any women willing to work in any capacity could become a member regardless of the caste or the religion by pledging of the dedication to the faith of the organization. Now, what are the challenges which you see and which you feel? During the rainy season, there is a space issue, the legal concerns, the fake papad distribution. What are the problems faced? Previously, the Lijjat was exempted from the sales tax for its product detergent, but recently the government has passed a provision under which the detergent is not included in PCPI, that is the processed cereal and pulses industries of the product list. So, the SMGULP have to pay the sales tax for the detergent product which they produce. The meeting is under process with the government to exempt this product also from the sale tax. The papads are made in the various parts of India. It is not a centralized production unit. The water is being used for making the papads. There is a varied quality of water in various parts which affect the final product. The final product is tested in the Lijjat's own laboratory in Mumbai to prevent these types of inconsistencies. There is another problem in front of Lijjat, that is the fake Lijjat Papad. Three persons were arrested in Bihar in June 2001, but the pitfall also exists in the international market. So definitely if you see the overall conceptual framework of Lijjat, they are so bothered for the quality, for the lens they put. Everything is tested in one laboratory which is in Mumbai, so that the water is different which is used across India to maintain the quality standards, to stay away from the discrepancy. The Lijjat Papad which is being produced is tested in laboratory before it is supplied to the market. So this is one vision for Lijjat, that they are for all quality products, maintaining all the quality standards so that they are able to build the trust amongst the people. And that is probably one of the major reasons for their success. Now, the Lijjat also face a problem of drying papads in the monsoon season, because it is very difficult to dry the papads outside and the system members have enough space to dry papads indoor in the rainy seasons, which affect the Lijjat export business in monsoon. So, you know, we are talking about so many limitations they have, so many problems they have. Still, they are the leaders. They have proved themselves to be a leaders. For them, to solve the problem is not a problem at all. Now, Lijjat faced another problem of the competition in the sales of their NASA detergent from existing established brands as Nirma. The quality standards of NASA Nirma, you know, they are competitive, the rates are competitive, so it's a clear-cut competitor in the market. The lack of advertisement may also be one of the reasons of this problem. So there's an urgency to increase the advertising and the direct selling for Lijjat Papad. Lijith is not directly involved in exporting, but make exporting through merchant exporters. Lijith can appoint its own distributors for exporting in the main countries and can increase the profit margins and definitely reduce the cost. Now we'll talk about the women empowerment. The organization has undertaken various efforts to promote the literacy and the computer education for the member sisters and their families. Because, you know, slowly, steadily, we are moving towards the digital India. To give and impart the computer education to the sisters who are involved in the business is very important. Only then can they be, you know, the star performers. They can add to the value and increase the sales and the value system for the Lijith Papad in India. So they do a lot of literacy campaignings for these sisters, which begin through literacy classes at Giragaon on 18th June 1999. The managing committee decided to start such classes in all its branches. In 1980 onwards, Lijith started giving Changa Bapa Simruti scholarships to the daughters of the member sisters. So they are so bothered for the sisters' development, for taking care of their families. So they are not only doing and imparting the education to the sisters, but also taking care of their family by giving certain scholarships to the children of those sisters. Now there are certain further developments also which are very important for them to see. In 1979, Lijith team up with UNICEF to organize a seminar in Mumbai on child care and mother welfare. As a part of the International Year of Child Celebrations, in October 1984, this Bhadrabet Bhatt represented Lijith at UNESCO sponsored international workshop, The Role of Women in Assimilation and Spread of Technological Innovation, held in Nitei, that is Powai. Alkabin Kalaya represented Lijith at the national level meeting on women convened by the National Commission on Self-Employed Women. Then they had a concept of certain awards. The Economic Times Awards to the institution for the Cooperative Excellence, Business Women of the Year Award on 6th of September 2002. The Best Village Industry Institution Award from then Honorable Prime Minister Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee Ji. Now we are coming on to Seva, that is the Ila Bhatt is the founder. So we will be discussing Seva in the coming session. So let me give you a recap of what we did today, that is the women empowerment through Lijith Papad. Now basically when you talk about the women in solidarity, that is the empowerment of cooperatives, a case study of women cooperatives in India. The first thing we talked about today was, you know, how the concept of cooperative started. We gave you a role of what women is all about. Women is all about stereotype role in the family. But yes, they were, you know, so important because of their skills they have, because of, you know, the kind of work only they can do, like embroidery, weaving, cooking, etc. She plays a very vital and a very predominant role in the Indian society because of her talent, but the only problem the Indian women faces is the, you know, the patriarchalism, the male dominance. So they had to depend upon, you know, for everything, for every small thing, on every trivial issue, onto their husbands, for the family earnings. So the needs of the family grew and there was a quite good need for the cooperative. So this led to the women cooperative movement in India. So, you know, we started with the concept of Lijith Papad with a seed capital of only rupees 80, which was also being taken as a loan from somebody. Then, of course, the Mahila Gram Lijith Papad, popularly known as Lijith, currently the president is Jyoti Nayak, the women cooperative involved in the manufacturing of various fast-moving consumer goods. They became leader in a very short while because of the dedication, because of the, you know, the sisters. They used to, you know, give a good time there without, you know, avoiding the work. The concept started only with a packets of four papads in 1959 with a very small turnover. As and when, you know, they grew, it increased many folds from just rupees 80 and you know, the annual turnover of 6196, it increased to about 1.82 lakhs in 62-63, and the story never stopped. It started with the, you know, certain founder sisters. All, you know, they were so vital, important because of their skills, because of whatever they had. So they saw a collective dreams which they tried to solve so that they can have a very comfortable life, a dignified livelihood, and they can be a contributor to the family for their earnings. So they started with the primary aim of maximizing the employment, women empowership, etc. So they started with a social service, distributing the nutritional food to the poor children, contributing money for the conducting the community marriage, the prize money to them. They started with some little awards also. So, you know, the work started in 58 houses, which increased to many, many millions. So they had a very good core values also. So this led to the success of the Lichit Papad. It increased the number of products. You know, they had, you know, used the latest advertisement techniques, etc., with a good management, solving all the basic problems which they had. And, you know, finally, they had certain awards which were so encouraging for them to become a leader. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Dear friends, here we come to the end of the half of this session, and we'll be continuing this topic after a really short break. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. Welcome back, friends. Today we are discussing the empowerment of women through a case study, that is of Lijjat Papad's. And to start this session, let's ask ma'am Namita Rajput to start it. But before starting it, I have a question, and let me ask it to ma'am. Ma'am, this Seva group or this Lijjat Papad, this is an empowerment to women's, but what are the else things that has added to the national economy or the national revenue, and how it has helped to raise the empowerment for women's, in which different ways?
Now, basically, when you talk about the Indian women had a very, you know, meager role.
Yeah.
They are so marginalized. There are so many factors contributing to it. One is patriarchalism, that is male dominance.
Yeah.
You know, the culture and everything is so that you cannot change the, you know, story in a day.
Hmm.
Owing to which, the role which was defined to them, it was very a stereotype role. That is, they are not supposed to go out.
Hmm.
Whatever are the earnings will be done by the males. So, whatever they give their wives, they have to, you know,
manage
with that.
Hmm.
So, it is so embedded in the culture of the Indian women that anything which is unconventional, you know, takes time to change. There are so many movements which took place because, you know, there was so much of domestic violence owing to money. Mm. They never used to give money. They used to earn money. But again, there are so many cases of starvation. There are so many cases of corruption.
Mm.
There are so many cases of, you know, the cruel acts against the women.
Domestic violence, you can say.
Everything.
Yeah.
You know, they used to drink and come to the houses, beat their women, so on and so forth.
Hmm.
So, you know, all these factors contributed a lot. The women became a very, you know, weaker sex, could not raise the voice.
Hmm.
So, you know, there were so many children, there was no family planning. There were about 7 to 8 children in each family.
Mm-hmm.
So what they used to do is, they just used to, you know, just, you know, drag the life, not live the life.
Yeah.
So these factors lead to rise in the needs of the children, of the family. So women slowly and steadily thought of working.
Mm-hmm.
So the only way, you know, which could match the standards and the custom was basically collecting. And the male also used to accept this culture that yes, females are working together.
Okay.
You know, it was not against the culture also.
Mm-hmm.
So that is why it led to the prolification and the success of the cooperative movements in India.
Yes.
You've seen this, the case study which I spoke. Now
yeah.
I'll talk about the Seva in the coming session. But Lijjat Papad started with 7 sisters.
Yeah.
You know, there are a few sisters whose names are not known because their contribution was so immense, but they never wanted to share their names.
Hmm.
So, the idea of getting together, all the women working together, so this kind of a culture was accepted by the males. So, which is again a big factor, because you cannot change the culture of a country. All these factors led to the success of the in this particular cooperative movements in India.
Yeah.
You see that how they used to work, they used to talk. So there was a release of the mental stress also of the women, because, you know, they share a lot of thoughts about their family, about their
and
about
their
problems, their experiences, their
yeah.
negativities. So this culture led to only the plus, 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 that is the success, success, success. One, they used to earn money. Two, they were, you know, slowly getting empowered. They could hide the money also for their own, you know, success. They could give a lot of nutritional foods to their children.
And more of else everything, they came up and they became self-confident.
Yeah. The self-reliance is there, self-confidence is there. They become the major contributors, of course. All these things led to their empowerment, their self-confidence. So, slowly, they started avoiding the conflicts with their husband, because used to happen when they're together.
Yes.
So, here, 8 to 9 hours, they were in factory.
Engaged in work, yeah.
So, you know, there was a, you know, dissect and a divorce kind of a thing.
Yes.
For male and women culture, at least, So this all led to women empowerment, so on and so forth, which is very good for the Indian economy.
Yes.
This led to the dawn of success of the cooperative movement in India, specifically about the women.
Yeah. So basically, we can say that this sort of cooperative initiations, they were a torch bearer for the women empowerment.
Yes, they were the torch bearers. They were the, you know, the stepping stone towards their new chapter of life, new journey of their life, new destination of their life.
Okay. So, ma'am, please continue with the next case study.
So, now we will be talking on Seva. The Ila Bhatt is the founder of Seva. She has pioneered the idea that the people themselves, no matter how poor or uneducated they are able to solve their own problems if they organize together to do so. The same kind of, ideas you could see with the Lijjat Papad also. They are the women united. Here also, basically, the ground reality is the same. The basic idea is the same. But yes, you have to pioneer yourself with your ideas to collect themselves, that even if you are poor, uneducated, but if you are united, if you are organized together, you can do wonders. Ila started as a lawyer with the Textile Labor Association, that is the TLA, in Ahmedabad. Working in women division, Ila soon found that women were doing many of the labor intensive tasks needed in the textile production as well as in the other fields of the work. However, as a worker, they were invisible. Now, there are seeds of inception of the growth and the journey which we'll talk about. Self-Employed Women Association, that is SEWA. Basically, in 1968, Ila asked to head the women wing of Textile Labor Association. Ila was aware that the thousands of wives and the daughters of the textile workers toiled to supplement the family income. No state laws protected these self-employed women. Self-employed women were not even included in 1971 census as workers. So this is a real sad state of affairs, that the women who are self-employed are not even a part of the census. How obnoxious it is. The self-employed women were unorganized, unprotected, economically very, very weak, and had no bargaining power. Ila determined the work for this segment of the population, which had a great impact on the economy, yet which was virtually forgotten in terms of the legal rights or protection of the interest. Now let us see what SEWA is all about. An organization of poor, self-employed women workers who used to earn a living through their own labor or small business. They do not obtain a regular salaried employment with the welfare benefits like workers in the organized sectors. They are unprotected labor force of our country. A confluence of the three movements, labor movements, cooperative movements, women movements, coming on to the goals of SEWA. Full employment and self-reliant of the women is the first important objective of SEWA. There are a lot of SEWA campaigns which we will be looking on now. Mass mobilization through campaigns in 1999, SEWA organized 10 campaigns. 1. Home-based women campaigns. 2. Vendors campaigns. 3. Forest workers campaign. Construction workers campaign. The water campaign. The food security campaign. The campaign for the right of child care. Campaign for recognition of midwives. Clean Ahmedabad campaign. Minimum wage campaign. And the campaign for recognition of unorganized sector divisions. What was the Ila's vision? According to Ila, considered to be a big fighter, values are most important to be instilled from the childhood. You have come together in an organized way, in an organization which the workers democratically and on certain values. Every 3 years, there should be elections in a very systematic way. Transparency, non-violence, equality, communal harmony are very important. She treasures a simplicity as a value. Simple needs and approach eliminates the need to lie and craving for more. Ela still emphasizes that there are no clear success or failures, more a series of small victorious and compromises. But the important thing is to keep going, keep on going. Now, Seva attracted many highly qualified women. For example, Meera Chatterjee, a master in public health from Johns Hopkins University. Reema Nanavati, a former IAS officer. Jayashree Vyas, former banker with the central bank, etc. They played and continue to play a crucial role in Seva activities and management. However, 80% of Seva executive committee consists of self-employed women who used to take decisions in a very democratic manner. According to Meera, we learnt from Mahatma Gandhi and others that when you want to change the things, you organize them, and until all citizens behind are the cause, especially the poorest of all. Where did this Seva movement started? It started in Gujarat. Cooperatives, 84 cooperatives with 11,610 members. DWCRA, that is the Rural Producers Group, 181 groups with 2981 members. Social Security Organizations, Saving and Credit Groups. When you talk about the membership, way back in 8-10-2006, self-employed workers, hawkers, vendors, small business women like vegetable, fruits, fish, egg, etc., other vendors of food items, home-based workers like weavers, potters, bidi, agarbatti, workers, papad rollers, ready-made garment workers, manual laborers, and the service providers like construction workers, contract laborers, handcraft pullers, memberships, agriculture workers. Just look at this particular Seva tree very, very carefully. It gives you a complete snapshot of their every network. This particular Seva tree, a women's support network, shows so many things together. The first is the vendor cooperatives, that is the kerosene vendors, vegetable suppliers, fish vendors. This is a vendor cooperatives. Second is artisans cooperatives, which talks about the weavers, bamboo workers, block printers, patch workers, and embroiderers. Then we have service cooperatives called childcare providers, industrial cleaners, waste paper collectors, community health workers, etc. Then we have land and animal cooperatives called wastelands, agro, forestry, dairy, and tree growers. Then we have group rallies, which talks about establishing the nexus, negotiations, lobbying, social security protest, identity cards, count cases, etc. The trade groups, the garment stitches, bidi rollers, head rollers, cart pullers, garment dealers, vendors, domestic workers, incense workers, scrap collectors, construction workers, papad rollers, carpenters, smiths, agriculture laborers, tobacco processors, and the fuel traders. So now we'll talk about the cooperatives, union, service and banks, which is called as Seva. The cooperatives, as we talked about, as market, raw material, skill management, training and contract. The union talk about the social security issues, implementation and enforcement, protective legislation and the policy support. And we talk about the services, we have about the childcare, training, communications, the legal aid. And when you talk about the banks, we have the savings, credit, life insurance, mortgage recovery, and the asset titles. So, you know, this is taken from a source called Kalima Rose, where women are the leaders. Now see the Seva support services. The first is the Seva Bank. It takes care of the health care, child care, legal services, work security insurance, housing insurance, video Seva, capacity building. We'll be taking it one by one. The first is the Seva Bank, the financial services arm of Seva. It was established in the year 1974 at the initiative of 4,000 self-women, women who contributed the share capital of rupees 10 each. Today, a fully regulated cooperative bank with more than 2,50,000 members offers its members a wide range of savings, credit and insurance. Though a majority of its loans are unsecured, it enjoys a repayment rate of more than 96%. The bank provides the loans to its members on the market rate with at least 3-year repayment period for the productive purposes. Now piloting, you know, a fourth area of the service, that is the financial education. Now if you see on the screens, there's a mechanism adopted by the bank to achieve its objectives. Recognize, understand in detail the financial problem of self-employed women. The mechanism is designed, procedures, adopt mechanism which are suitable to them, adopt methods of operation through which they can come out these financial problems. And the rationale is that the Seva wants to help its members to be proactive, forward-looking, to be able to plan and utilize the financial services for more than secure and comfortable future. There are certain problems which are faced and there are certain solutions which are offered to them. So, we'll talk about the problem saved first. The indebtedness paying high rates of interest are very, very important problem. Providing loan for replying the old debts at a comparatively lower rate of interest. The borrowed working capital paying high rates of interest, providing loans for the working capital at lower rate of interest. Hired equipment paying rent of the equipment, providing loans for the buying equipment. So these are the basic problems which we have to see and manage as the Seva banks are concerned. There are certain Seva bank statistics in front of you which can give you an overview. In 2003 and 4, the total members were 34,835. In 2004 and 5, it increased to 44,938. So there's a rise of 10,103 members. Similarly, there's a rise of the share capital of 26,45,000. The accounts, debts, working capital, number of loans, loans and advances, and the profits. Everything, if you see on the screens, they show a rise in the Seva Bank services. Now coming on to Seva Health. They have very important features to be seen. Seva Health operates a cooperative consisting of the midwives and the health cum educators. Providers curative care, preventive health care. It promotes the health awareness of the workers and the family. Average health care expenses from 131 to 74 per household. Seva team of 200 midwives and the health workers serve as health. Educators come barefoot doctors for 75,000 women workers. Capacity building of local women, especially the traditional midwives, so that they become the barefoot doctors of the communities, villages, emphasizing self-reliance. Women-centered healthcare led by the local women, including occupational health, reproductive health, maternal health, mental health and nutrition. Linking the health services to insurance, provision of basic amenities like sanitation, literacy and other development programs. If you see this snapshot of the Seva health care, we have the health education number one, because education can do wonders. Immunization is there, sanitation activities are there, family planning is there, education, healthcare is there, and of course, injuries, suicide, cancer, ulcers, they are taken care of. Then medicines in relation to the low cost health centers are also provided. So this is a total seva health care approach to them. Then we have a child care at seva. Child care centers, they take care of the children during the working hours for the women workers. Seva has opened 73 such centers in which when the women is working, the children are not ignored. The centers provide the healthcare, basic education and the meals for the children and counseling to the mothers. And there are certain child care initiatives which are also taken by Seva. The Seva children through cooperatives and the local organizations. Sangini Child Care Workers Cooperatives Ahmedabad, running the centers for infant and the young children. It has linked with the ICDS and the social welfare boards. Then the Shashu Childcare Workers Cooperatives, that is the Kheda district. The Balvikas Mandal and the local organization, Surinder Nagar districts, and the Banasakha DWCRA Mahila Seva Association. All these, you know, centers, they take care of the women, their children, nurseries, collecting, you know, and giving them the services, etc. Seva work security schemes are there in which the life, natural and the accidents are covered, health is covered, maternity benefits are given, flood, fire, communal benefits are extended to them. Widowhood options are also taken care of in case of the accidental deaths. Capacity programs are given to them. Then about the housing and the infrastructure is given to them. That is the members to build their repair and their houses. The trust understands that the house for the home-based workers is also a production unit and helps them for their work-related needs, etc. Then some kind of legal services are offered to them. Then, of course, the video programs are given. Sustainability issues are taken care of. That is, they're meant for both financial self-sufficiency as well, taking your own decisions so that you are just a beneficiary or the user of the program. Then about the flexibility, timings, etc. The structure has evolved that gives Seva a great flexibility to grow and respond to the members. Needs for the formal education governance. Members are engaged by the union cooperatives and the member services are there. Financial sustainability is provided to them. About 55% of the total cost are covered by the member fees. Grant and donations are accounted for about 45%, and international affiliations are given to the international labor bodies, etc. The last question, is Seva successful? The answer is yes. It is taking care of the child, it is taking care of the nutrition, taking care of so many aspects, paradigms and the frontiers of the women in all. So we can say that yes, Seva is quite successful. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for sharing such a motivational case study with our viewers. Dear friends, I am sure that this would have motivated you as well, because small efforts and initiatives can also bring great success stories. So always stay motivated and informed. We at CEC are always ready with such educational and informational lectures for you. Stay tuned. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks again.